We are here to know how to collect the swab in COVID-19 patient. The purpose of the throat and nasal swab culture is to detect the presence of the organism which is causing infection. We have to ensure a good quality specimen for the identification of the virus, and we have to avoid contamination of the specimen. The ideal specimen is the bronchoalveolar lavage. In this, the test being positive are 93%, but it is very costly, time consuming, and much more healthcare workers are exposed. So we prefer nasal swab and pharyngeal swab. Nasal swab, the chances of test being positive are 63%. Pharyngeal swab, the chances of test being are 32%. These are the guidelines, ICMR guidelines, which may change or which may update. Now, while collecting the respiratory swab, we must be aware how the virulence of the virus, that is how harmful the virus could be, and also we should be aware the infectious of the virus. The equipment list needed for collecting swab are the nasopharyngeal swab with plastic flexible shaft with viral transport media, facial tissue, flashlight, alcohol-based hand rub, disinfectant wipes, containers, transport bag, patient label, permanent ink ballpoint, absorbent pads. Now what doctor needed? Doctor needed is complete personal protective equipment. Now, when we are collecting the nasopharyngeal swab or throat swab, the patient is very anxious, he is scared. So we must talk to the patient, we must make him comfortable so that he should be relieved from the anxious. We should explain in his own language. We should take verbal consent. If required, if also patient is scared, then we should take for assistance, for help. And if patient is child, then we should use distraction techniques. Position of the patient: if patient is in sitting position, his head and back should rest. If patient is in standing position, he should take support of the wall. For bedside patient, propped up position is must. Now doctor should always stand on the right side of the patient in case patient sneezes or cough. While collecting the swab, he must not get contaminated. With the flashlight or headlight, we should check for any nasal abnormality or oropharyngeal abnormality. Then the equipment should be prepared in serial order. Unnecessary equipments are avoided. During the collecting the swab should be held into the thumb and the index finger. The shaft is to be rested on the middle finger. We have to place the left hand or non-dominant hand on patient's forehead. It should be gentle. With mindful, we have to collect the sample. Whenever we are inserting the swab, always ask the patient to clinch his eyes as it will inhibit the sneeze reflex. Once the desired level of the swab is inserted into the nose, that is, which should be parallel to the floor of the nose and touching the septum and the lateral wall, we have to rotate there slowly for 2 to 3 times and keep the swab for the few seconds so that it absorbs the secretion. Once it is done, we have to remove the swab and seal it properly. After sealing it properly, we have to wash the container with the alcohol-based sanitizer, label it properly. We have to fill the form. We have to insert that into the transport bag, and this transport bag is also cleaned by the alcohol-based sanitizer. Now, same is for the collection of the throat swab. We have to stand on the right side of the patient. Place the non-dominant hand on the forehead. Ask the patient to open the mouth. If the exposure is inadequate, use disposable tongue depressor. Insert the swab into the mouth, avoiding contamination of the saliva. Rub on the posterior pharyngeal wall or tonsillar pillars, tonsillar fossa. Once the procedure has been done, seal the swab into the container which is having viral transport media, and then label it properly, sterile with the alcohol based sanitizer, and insert it into the transport bag with foam, and then this transport bag is also cleaned with the alcohol based sanitizer. Then if we are sending the specimen and if it has been tested within the 72 hours, it should be stored at 2 to 8 degrees Celsius, and if we are expected or if there is delay in sending the sample more than the 72 hours, then it should be stored at minus 70 degrees or below. Thank you.
I'm Dr. Sunil Khod, ENT department lecturer from GMC Miraj. I will just demonstrate the swab collection from the oral cavity, that is posterior pharyngeal wall. Mama, tumcha naav kay?
Sanjay.
Okay, apan fakt he COVID-19 cha awareness swab collection demonstrate karat ahe. See, I am speaking in the patient's language to make the patient comfortable with me. Okay, ata ha kapsacha pola मी तुमच्या घशाला टच करणार आहे आणि त्याचं स्वॅब कलेक्शन घेणार आहे. तर याच्यात काही त्रास होत नाही, काय होत नाही. चुकून खोकला आला तर त्या बाजूला हे करून खोकू शकता तुम्ही. ओके, खोकताना खोकर पुढे घ्या. ओके, कसं आलं, काय शंका?
काय नाही.
ओके, तोंड उघडा. आ बोला. आय विल नॉट कंटॅमिनेट विथ दिस सलायवा, दॅट इज आय विल नॉट टच बक्कल म्युकोझा. And tongue, I will directly enter the posterior pharyngeal wall. Just touch for 2 to 3 seconds and will come outside. I will demonstrate the nasal swab collection. Okay, mama, hey, baga, tumcha doka patimagun bhintila touch kara. Okay, I am going to raise the patient's head and I will just take the nasal swab. Nakat atta kasu kapus yel, ha, kai ghabru naka. Shink ali tar tya bajula kiwa kopar var shinka. Okay. I will rest the forehead with non-dominant hand. I will stand on the right side of the patient. I will just enter parallel to the floor of the nose. Touch the septum. Okay. Lateral wall. I will rotate for 2 seconds and I will just remove.